Good morning, everyone. We want to welcome you to our science demonstration entitled The Force That Affects Us All. There are many laws of nature. For example, there's Newton's three laws of motion about inertia and force and acceleration and about opposite reactions. There's also the law of gas under pressure. There are the laws of genetics that we've learned from Mendel. Einstein has helped us with some laws of relativity. There are laws of energy, thermodynamics, for example. But the law that most of us are aware of just about all the time is the law of gravity. All of these laws that I have mentioned affect all of us equally all the time. But the law that we're most conscious of is this law of gravity. It affects us whether we are sleeping, like this little kitty cat is, whether we're eating, like this chipmunk with his pouches full, whether we're working or playing, walking, sitting, standing, everything we do is affected by this law of gravity. Now the question I have for you is, does size matter? Does the law of gravity affect people who are bigger than people who are smaller? Does size matter? What do you think, Ashley? She's shaking her head. No, it doesn't matter. Is it important? Well, and in slide 13 we have a beautiful little damselfly on a stalk of grass or wheat there. Well, in slide 14, you will see a little creature on the water. This is a water strider. And it's true, the law of gravity affects water striders, but there is a law of science or nature that affects him more. And that's called the law, so to speak, of surface tension of water. He is able to walk on water or to stay suspended on water because of the surface tension of the water, so that law is more important than the law of gravity for the little water strider. Now, there's nothing too large or too small for God to notice. Even the hairs of our head are numbered, and I know that this little creature doesn't have hair. He has feathers, but God knows about all of his feathers. Now, we want, in this demonstration, you will only need, you'll need two pitchers, each half filled with water, a basin to catch the water, a foot-long piece of string that's been soaked in water, and tape. And a glass. Okay, now what we're going to do, if I should pour some water out of this pitcher, the law of gravity would have the water go straight down, right?
Yes.
Okay, and because there's surface tension in the water, it doesn't come out in chunks. It kind of flows because the molecules stick together. Okay? Now that's the law of gravity. With also consideration to surface tension. Now what I need to do is to get, and I need some help here, Ashley. I need to get some tape, and would you cut off a piece for me, please? Maybe we can just tear it. Now I need another piece about that size, if you could get that for me. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to tape the end of this piece of string, and then inside this glass we're going to tape it to the bottom. And let me move this over so we can put this right up here and tape that to the bottom. Thank you, Ashley. Tricky to get it to stay put, but I think it will. Now what we want to do is take our pitcher, aim this string over the spout of the pitcher, and then tie it to the handle. Let's see, how did I do this last time? There's an easy way. Let me think. what why we're doing this is to keep this string as taut as we can across the spout, because now we're going to pour water into this glass with this string across it. Now, Ashley, what do you think? Is it going, oh, we better use this also. Put this up here. Do you think the water is going to fall out like it did before?
No. What but you need to put it up top.
I know. What do you think is going to happen?
I think it's going to not do it.
Well, if we're careful. Now, remember, there's the law of gravity that we talked about, and also the law of surface tension of water molecules. And so what I want to do is to pour this out slowly enough that hopefully, I can't see where the water is, that it will, the surface tension of the water will, I wish I could see what we got, there we go, the surface of the tension of the water will overcome the gravity. See, it's going down the string instead of falling by gravity into, do you see that, Ashley?
Yes.
This, and we soaked the string so that it would work better. But there the water is going down. The surface tension is holding it in place, and it's going down the string. Now, the reason I'm showing this to you is this world we live in can attract us and pull us down, just like gravity can pull, has a force on everything on this world. This, the world that's around us, the things that we like to read and see and eat and do and dress and all of that, is an influence from the world, and it pulls us down. But if we stay close to Jesus, we will be like this water that trickled down the string because of the surface tension of the water, and He will help us overcome the pull of the world away from Him. So staying close to Jesus is like the surface tension of the water molecules, and that can overcome the force of gravity in a way, because it still goes down. Gravity is still pulling it. And if I poured it out, it would the force of gravity would overcome the surface tension. But if we stay close to Christ, He can help us overcome the pull of the world. In fact, He will help us overcome the pull of the world away from Him. And that's our little science demonstration for now. And thank you for joining us. And we will be back next Sabbath, Lord willing.